Hello, welcome in Amsterdam. What do you think of when I'm going to speak about the management of urban water systems? Is it merely the management of this surface water system, this canal here? Or is there more to it? What are the responsible organizations, their roles and responsibilities in managing these waters? And who has an interest, a stake in the management and the appropriate management of these systems? What I'm going to introduce in this video is who is responsible and what the pathways of the water will be. Let us take a look at the slide showing the pathways of the water. As you can see, the flow of the water in the small water cycle or the water chain is relatively straightforward. Water is flowing from the drinking water system into the wastewater system, and from the wastewater system to the wastewater treatment plant. On the other hand, rainfall that runs off as stormwater can go many ways. It could flow to the wastewater treatment plant via a combined sewer system, or it could flow into the urban surface water via storm sewers. In a combined sewer system, part of the wastewater can escape from the sewer system during heavy rainstorms. Such combined sewer overflows end up in the surface water and heavily pollute them. Part of the stormwater runs off, however, and another part infiltrates into the urban soil on unpaved and permeable paved surfaces, and thus feeds the groundwater. The groundwater is either used by vegetation for evaporation, or it drains into the local surface water. In some cases, it is just the other way around. Upward seepage of the regional groundwater system goes to the local groundwater system and feeds the urban water system. This is what we call the urban water system or the small urban water system. As you can see, urban water creates a complex network of pathways. Depending on the design of the urban infrastructure, stormwater and drinking water go their own way and support or hinder the life in the urban environment. This complexity is also reflected in the management of the water system. As we can see in the next slide, the different components of the water chain each have their own responsible manager. Imagine what that means for the management of the total flow, with each component having a different manager. The management of the urban water system is even more confusing. Parts of each system are managed by different organizations, and only via intensive cooperation between the various authorities, private parties and residents can an effective management of water quantity and water quality be achieved to the benefit of all stakeholders. Whether urban surface water is managed by the municipality or by the water authority depends on the nature and the type of the water. The management of the urban groundwater system is in the hands of the landowner, which means that the municipality is responsible for the groundwater management on public land, while each landowner must manage the groundwater level on their own private land. But if they want to extract groundwater via a private well, they need permission from the water authority or even from the province. Issues such as spatial planning and design, choices in construction material and methods for paved and unpaved areas, urban green infrastructure, and making space for water belong to the responsibility of the municipality if they are on public land. However, all have an impact on the quantity and the quality of urban water. But residents and private parties are responsible for what happens on private land, such as gardens and business plots. So citizens all have their own share in managing the urban water system. The complexity of the urban water system and the pathways of the water definitely produce a number of challenges in the management of these systems. For a comprehensive management of the water system here in Amsterdam, the city has created a special organization called Waternet. Waternet is an umbrella organization that covers all the components mentioned before, from the water chain, the drinking water supply, water collection, wastewater treatment, including the responsibilities and tasks of the water authorities for the surface water management and the groundwater management of the city. So now I've showed you what the water system of Amsterdam looks like, what the pathways of the water are, and who is responsible for the management, and who has an interest, a stake in the water management here in Amsterdam.